Good afternoon. I greet you all in the wonderful name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. At this time, I invite Brother Lincoln to the podium for our scripture reading.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Your scripture today is taken from 1 Thessalonians 4, number 13 to 18. But I would not have you to be ignorant, brethren, concerning them which are asleep, that ye sorrow not, even as others which have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so, them also which sleep in Jesus will God bring with him. For this we say unto you, by the word of the Lord, that we which are alive and remain unto the coming of the Lord shall not prevent them which are asleep. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, and with the voice of archangel, and with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Then which we are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds, to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we ever be with the Lord. Wherefore, comfort one another with these words. Amen and amen. Praise the Lord.
Amen. At this time, I invite you all to stand as we're going to join in a hymn, What a Friend We Have in Jesus.
Now this is a common hymn, but it's a hymn that is sung anywhere you go into funerals. And I believe some of you, if you are a non-churchgoer even, you must somehow remember the words, the tune. Let us sing, What a Friend We Have in Jesus.
What a friend we have in Jesus. All our sins and griefs to bear. What a privilege to carry everything to God in prayer. Oh, what peace we often forfeit. Oh, what needless pains we bear. All because we do not carry everything to God in prayer. Have we trials and temptations? Is there troubles anywhere? We should never be discouraged. Take it to the Lord in prayer. Can we find a friend so faithful, who will all our sorrows share? Jesus knows our every weakness. Take it to the Lord in prayer. Are we weak and heavy laden? Come but with a load of care. Precious Savior, still our refuge. Take it to the Lord in prayer. Do thy friends despise, forsake thee? Take it to the Lord in prayer. In his arms he'll take and shield thee. Thou wilt find a solace there.
Amen. We go right into the second song, When the Roll is Called Up Yonder, I'll Be There. Amen. I know we are in a funeral service, but we can go a little with a little tempo on this one, okay?
Praise the Lord. When the trumpet of the Lord shall sound, and time shall be no more, and the morning breaks eternal bright and fair. Oh, when the saved of earth shall gather, you're on the other shore, and the world is called up yonder, I'll be there. Oh, when the roll is called up yonder, 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 I'll be there. On that bright and cloudless morning, when the dead in Christ shall rise, and the glory of his resurrection shine, when the chosen ones shall gather to their homes beyond the sky, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. Oh, when the roll is called up yonder, 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 I'll be there. Let us labor for the Master from the dawn till setting sun. Let us talk of all his wondrous love and care. And then when all of life is over and the work on earth is done, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. Oh, when the roll is called up yonder, 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 I'll be there. Oh, when the roll is called up yonder, 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 I'll be there. Praise the Lord. And those who don't know, if your name is on that roll, I think you're in the right place, the right time, among the right people, in the right circumstances, to make sure your name is on the roll. Make sure you're standing on the rock and your name is on the roll. God bless you. You can have your seats. Amen.
Go ahead. At this time, I invite Krishanta Maharaj and Kamira Britton with the eulogy.
Brothers and sisters, family, friends, neighbors, and well-wishers, we gather here today to celebrate the life of a truly extraordinary person, Harrylal Britton, commonly known to most as Kenneth and to us as Nana and Aja. Although it is difficult to capture the essence of such a person in a few words, Nana's passing has left a great dent in our hearts, and we must honor him by giving him a proper send-off in the way that he wished.
HARRYLAL Britton was born on the 7th of December 1947 and lived a full 75 years of life. He was the firstborn of Reynald Britton and Molly Supersad, and the eldest of his five siblings. He had a marriage with his wife Sylvia Britton that lasted 50 years. Since birth, he lived his life full of meaningful moments and cherished memories with his family and friends. Before becoming a grandfather, he lived a youthful life that was filled with insatiable curiosity, always eager to learn and explore. The curiosity was the driving force behind so many of his accomplishments. He was a person most described as easygoing and joyful, always cracking a joke and sharing laughs. At such a difficult time, it is important to remember the good memories we shared with Aja. Aja was not only a friend to many, but a son, brother, father, husband, and grandfather. His kindness and compassion knew no bounds, and he was a person who was always ready to lend a hand to his loved ones.
Ever since, Nana has always shown a significant interest in hunting. This passion continued throughout his life, eventually passing down his love for his hobby to his son, Suresh Britton, which they enjoy together. And although Grandpa has passed, his son will always continue their hunting tradition. To his daughter, Kavita Maharaj, he was a true inspiration and a remarkable man that she looked up to. One of their most treasurable moments to her are the times when he would stop at Christine's in the bar before dropping her to work to buy a soft pigeon while he enjoyed his beverage. His dedication and hard work earned him respect and admiration from his family and friends. The most notable memory I can recall were the times when Nana carried us for drives in town, always eager to spend time with his grandchildren, especially at the mud volcano in Hindustan, which he knew we enjoyed the most. To his eldest grandson, Kiran Maharaj, the fondest memory he can recall is a time on Christmas when his Nana had bought him a fire truck that he had always wanted and tried to keep it a surprise, but Kiran found where he had hidden it. To Nana, Kiran was his IT technician, always programming the TV so he could watch his beloved Western shows.
As a baby, Aja used to call me his pumpkin, which became his nickname for me that stuck throughout my life. To everyone, he always introduced me as, "Dai my eyeball and dai my pumpkin." He was the first person who taught me how to stick fight. I remembered every day after school, I was always eager to go upstairs so we could play stick fighting. And he introduced our game by singing our team song, "Ba man coming down the road, ba man coming down the road." It was one of my favorite hobbies to bond with my Aja. He always told me that we would have gone stick fighting competition and give them stick fighters some competition.
As well as his daughter-in-law Trisha Britton, his partner in crime, whom he always enjoyed going out with in his free time and who always made him his favorite fruits. And his niece, his Laura Flora, who grew up like a second daughter to him. Her dearest memory were the days Nana used to bring her cakes every Friday evening. Lastly, his son-in-law, Danish Maharaj, who was also of utmost importance to him as their heartfelt talks and stories of his work in Petrichin will forever be cherished. It is difficult to say goodbye to someone who was of unconditional importance in our lives, but we must hold these memories closest to our hearts and find comfort in knowing that his memories will forever remain with us.
In closing, let us remember HARRYLAL Britton for his kindness, passion, and unwavering love for those closest to him. As we bid farewell to his remarkable soul, may we find comfort in knowing that he lived a life filled with joy and happiness.
At this time, we are open for tributes. Anyone of the congregation would like to come up and say anything on behalf of the deceased? If not, I invite you all to stand. As we welcome the man of God with the word of God, let us all welcome Brother Mohan.
Ready? All right. Just keep standing for a minute or two for the reading of our scripture this evening. I'll let you know that I'm reading from the Bible. The book of 1 Corinthians, chapter 15, taken from the 55th verse, "O death, where is thy sting? O grave, where is thy victory? The sting of death is sin, and the strength of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, which giveth us the victory through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen." Father, we thank you as we go into your precious word. We pray that you will give us hearing ears, no wonder why you spoke in parables and says, Lord, whosoever hath an ear, let him hear. So give us hearing ears, spiritually hearing ears this evening, this congregation, Lord, this fear congregation, Lord. Remove the wax of spiritual dullness, Lord, that your word will enter into the hearing and into their hearts, and will germinate, bring forth fruit unto repentance. We pray, O God, we thank you for what you're going to do here this evening. Bless us. You have blessed your word above all measure, Lord. So bless now thy servant as I minister your precious word. We thank you, for we ask it in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you. You can have your seats. Our scripture reading brought us to the second verse, that, O death, where is thy sting? Somewhere along the line, maybe all of us have gotten a sting from somebody or something. Men, talking about little Jack Spaniards and so. But you know, some people have sting. You have to be careful about people's sting, not only the insects in them, right? That's just for free, that's just a little humor. But what I'm going to talk about is very important. The sting of death. There is a sting in death for all of us, but for the child of God, the Bible tells us, blessed are they who die in the Lord. And through Jesus Christ, I don't want to preempt what I want to preach, but through the Lord Jesus Christ and his work on Calvary, he has removed the sting of death. Amen? He has removed the sting of death. The Bible tells us, Paul says in the book of Galatians, somewhere in the 6th chapter, he says, be not deceived. God will not be mocked. For whatsoever a man soweth, that shall he also reap. For if you sow to the flesh, you will reap corruption. And if you sow to the Spirit, you will reap everlasting life. For the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. As we get right into our service, just a little bit of humor again. I feel you all looking at me too hard and too starchy. You know, you're driving around Napurimamiya Road near the cemetery. All right, our New Grand Cemetery, not ours. New Grand Cemetery, okay? And you see the sign, New Grand Cemetery, your final resting place. Ladies and gentlemen, what a theological jargon, I call it. I always, you know, I pass around my wife's and I say, look at that. What a theological jargon. Ladies and gentlemen, New Grand Cemetery is not your final resting place. When you're dead, you're not done. When you're dead, you're just begun. Ladies and gentlemen, as really as you see this preacher standing here today, there is an eternity ahead. For whatsoever man soweth, that shall he also reap. Only two places, as I said in my prayer, God holds the balances of life and death in his hand. He adds up the sum total of your life, places it on that balance. And I'm wondering if you know what tips the scale. There are only two things, good or evil, and life or death. There's only two places. Our brother has walked his way, his last step out of this world. As I was saying, nobody knew. Nobody knows the condition of the soul when he left this earth. You know, you all know about the thief on the cross. He had a last minute experience and a last minute conversion to get to heaven. Jesus says, today you are going to be with me in paradise. So nobody knew. what transpired during the last breath that he took. That sting of death. In the book of Malachi, the prophet declares there is a book of remembrance. And in that book will be opened. It's recording every single thing that you do and you say. The record, sum total of you, what you have done every day, every word spoken, every thought, every generous act, every kind deed has been recorded for you or against you. Every evil overcame and every self-sacrifice made for God is written down in that book. There are two books that will be opened, as far as the Bible is concerned, in the judgment. The book of remembrance and the book of life. Two books. Can you, if you shut your eye tonight and get up tomorrow morning on the wrong side of life, and God picks up that book of remembrance and throws it at you, I wonder if you can even stand before the presence of Almighty God as he reads the things that you have done in your life, whether it be good or whether it be evil. Oh, the wonderful ledger the angels keep, and the watchful eyelids that never sleep, and the tireless penmen who watch and weep over the things they write. To face such a record in those books, Paul declares that every one of us will be summoned. Every one of us will be summoned before the judgment seat of Almighty God. Ladies and gentlemen, you have somebody who is your lawyer in heaven this afternoon. He's our mediator with the Father. He stands before God. When we sin against Almighty God, and in the justice of God's scales and balances, he will strike us down. Jesus looks at that blood, that basin of blood in heaven that he shed on the cross of Calvary nigh 2,000 years ago, and says to his Father, Father, for my sake and for the blood that I shed for him and for her, forgive him and forgive her. And that is a continuous thing. That smoke of mediatorship goes on continuously in heaven for this human race. Okay. The sting of death. Death is a robber of life. He robs the master out of the masterpiece. He recklessly removes the beauty from the beautiful. Death takes the fellow out of fellowship. He silences the laughter of the happy. Death paralyzes the hand of the sculptor of life and crumbles the marble on which the sculptor is working on. Death removes the color from the picture of life and stains the mirror into which we look at life. Death removes the architect and brings ruin to the building in which our life is housed. God saw our dear brother, departed brother. God saw that the building was falling apart. He saw that the roof was caving in. He saw the walls were caving in. And he saw that the very foundation on which that building was standing on was being removed. And God removed him and God took him away. The sting of death. The first thing I want to look at death is, death is no respecter of persons. Rich and poor. Healthy or wealthy, good or bad, prince or pauper, we're equal 6 feet under or in the fire in the cremation site. There's no rich man, there's no poor man at death. Death is the great equalizer. He equalizes all of us 6 feet under or in the fires at the cremation site. Death is no respecter of persons. He comes rich and poor, healthy, wealthy, happy, sad, whoever. He is no respecter of persons. He doesn't respect your official standing in society, or how big your job is, or how what position you have, where in what place of business, or if you're a professor at the university, or what. We all will die one day and leave this world, and death is no respecter of persons. Number two, death cannot be bribed. If life was something money could buy, the rich would live and the poor would die. But not so. We just cannot bribe Mr. Death. Hello, are you with me this evening? Right. Okay, I know you're here now. He cannot be bribed. Our judicial system, you can bribe your way through. Don't talk about the political system, it's gone. The social system, the moral system is gone. You know, the older folks like myself, I've gone on to 70 years and 10 and I'm going on, and I just can't understand this younger generation. We who came from that side just can't understand them. Our morality, our moral standing, and our moral, what is saying, system is gone. But you just cannot bribe death. You can bribe your way any kind of any kind of problems you have. I don't have to talk to you. We have crooked lawyers. We have crooked judges. I don't want to pull down anybody saying, do we have any policemen in our congregation? We have crooked policemen also. All right? We have, anywhere you go. And our systems are compromised. And you can bribe your way through any kind of problem you have today, but you cannot bribe Mr. Death. Cannot be bribed. He doesn't want your money. You just cannot bribe him. Number three, death cannot be put off. Okay? You just cannot put death off. Death comes with reckless footsteps to the hall and to the hut. Think you death will tarry knocking where the door is shut? You just can't put him off. Amen. Think. You can put off any appointment with the Prime Minister. Or you can put off an appointment with the Governor General. No, with the Governor General, all right? You're for a big job in some big company. You can put it off. You get sick real bad. You hit the hospital. You just have to put it off. But this is one appointment you just cannot put off. You cannot put off. He will not be turned down, Mr. Death. You feel you're putting too much emphasis on Mr. Death? No, I'm not here to glorify Mr. Death, you know. I'm here to tell you about his works. I'm here to expose him about his runnings and what he does. So you just cannot put off Mr. Death. You cannot put off that appointment. Whether you're in the air, he's going to catch you up in the air. If you're in the bottom of the ocean, he's going to catch you there. Wherever you are, on a sick bed, in a hospital, well and happy or jolly, on the highway, he's going to pick you up right there. Mr. Death, you just cannot put off Mr. Death. Number four, you cannot escape death. You just can't escape him. The king's servant went to the marketplace and he saw Mr. Death walking around in the market. So he got scared and ran back to the palace and says, "Hey, Mr. King, I saw Mr. Death in the market just now and he aroused me. Give me your fastest horse and I'm going to go into my hometown of Samaria and I'm going to hide in Samaria." The next day, the king saw Mr. Death and said, "Hey, you harassed my servant yesterday in the marketplace." He said, No, I did not harass your servant yesterday in the marketplace, but I do have an appointment with him today in Samara. You just can't escape him. Okay? The king lives up on top of the castle, 100 steps. You know how much you make? 100 steps. All right? And Mr. Death came to the castle. He said, well, I'm not going to walk up all the steps. I'm not interested in the king. He met the servant at the bottom of the steps. And said, you know something? It's time. Let's go. You just can't escape Mr. Death. We cannot run. If you take the ship into a submarine to the bottom of the ocean, he's going to pick you up right there. Number five, death is no sympathizer of the human race. It's happening all around us every day. We just can't get over it. We just can't get around it. But to tell you something, something happens when it comes to your doorsteps, when it comes home to you. When the coffin comes rolling into the old house, you realize in the cold sense of death, there's a numbness, there is a reality, there is something we just cannot understand. Why? Why, Lord? Why? And there are many people who tug at their lives and pull at their hearts and cry out, why, Lord, why? And only God in heaven understands. The Bible tells us Jesus Christ was going to preach into the city in the city of Nain. And a funeral was coming down the road. You know, it's bad manners to keep on walking when the funeral is coming down. So he stopped, he and his band of little disciples. And he saw this funeral coming from the city of Nain. And there was the mother pulling at her hair and beating her chest and crying and sobbing because her husband had died. And now the only breadwinner was her son, and he has passed away now. And Jesus, with a heart of compassion, I said all that to tell you that Mr. Death is no sympathizer of the human race. As I said, it's happening all about us. The coldness and the numbness and the reality. Little, when you go to the cemetery, you see small little graves. It gives us a cold reality that little babies die. Young people die. You know, and you say, well, all right, if they hit the 70s and into the 80s, four scores years, you know. Well, all right. But when the reality hits you of young people and so much people dying on our roadside and the death toll, the murder toll in Trinidad is so high, and it's frightening and it's disgusting. And Mr. Death is no sympathizer to the human race. Okay, I change my focus now to let you know the sting of death has been removed. Nigh 2,000 years ago, on the old rugged cross of Calvary, outside the city of Jerusalem, the central cross became the pivotal point of history. In some mysterious way, God took all the sin of mankind and placed it upon his only begotten son, the bosom of his heart, and placed it on his son. Listen to me, the Roman government couldn't kill Jesus. He was whipped with 39 stripes at the whipping post. Many a convict died at the pavement, the Gabbatha, outside the court of the temple. Many, many people were beaten there, criminals and convicts were beaten and they died. But Gabbatha, the whipping post, couldn't kill Jesus. He carried that cross up the Appian Way, 70 steps up the Appian Way to level off to go to Golgotha. And when he crossed it, somebody helped him. A man called Simeon helped him to bear the cross. The Bible tells us God For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Amen. Jesus Christ took the sting out of death. Not only that, they took him down from the cross and they put him in a borrowed tomb and they rolled a heavy stone. And they watched the grave for three days and three nights. And the Bible tells us on the third day, he rose triumphantly from the dead. Amen. He made a show of them openly by triumphing over the dead. He triumphed over principalities and powers. He rose again over death, hell, and the grave. Ladies and gentlemen, through the power of the resurrection in Christ Jesus, he removed the sting of death. So those who believe in him, as he told Mary, I am the resurrection and the life. He who believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. And he who believeth in me shall never die. You must have heard this talk before. If you're born once, you're going to die twice. And if you're born once, you're going to die twice. But if you're born twice, you're going to die once. Amen. He who believeth on the Lord Jesus Christ and is baptized shall be saved. Jesus Christ took the sting out of death. No wonder we grieve and we cry at funerals. But the child of God, the Christian, has a hope beyond the grave, that there is life. There is an eternity with Christ and life in heaven. We have a mansion. We have a hope shown steadfast in the heavens, Jesus Christ, the righteous Son of the living God. Jesus Christ died, the holy for the unholy, the unjust, the just for the unjust, the good Jesus Christ for the bad, the incorruptible for we the corruptible. He died, the immortal man, we who are mortal men. Jesus Christ died so that we can be saved from the power of death, hell, and the grave. I close with an invitation. It comes not from Brother Mohan, but from the throne room of God. It comes from the Word of God. It comes from the mouth of the Lord Jesus Christ. It comes from our lawyer in heaven this evening, our mediator with the Father. It comes with our advocate from our advocate in heaven. Matthew 11 and 28 tells us, come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you, learn of me. For I am meek and lowly in heart, you shall find rest unto your souls. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light. Come for spiritual rest to Jesus Christ. If you need a haven for rest, come to Jesus. If you need a shelter in the time of the storms that come against your life, come to Jesus. He is a shelter in the time of storm. If you need a strong tower, somewhere where you can hide from the blast of the enemy, come to Jesus. He's a strong tower from the winds that blow against your life today. He's a refuge for your soul. You need somewhere to anchor your soul that is sure you can do it upon the Lord Jesus Christ. Number two, Isaiah 1 and 18 tells us, come now, it's very urgent. Time is closing up. Eternity is just before us. Come now, it's an urgent call. Let us reason together, said the Lord. Though your sins be as scarlet, they shall be white as snow. And though they be red like crimson, they shall be like wool. God wants to talk over the sin situation and the sin problem that is in your life today. You need a good amount of breeze and tide to wash your clothes and make it clean. You need the blood of Jesus Christ to make your heart and your soul clean and white. You need the blood of Jesus Christ And that alone can clean up your life. The dirt and the muck that is in your soul and in your heart, Jesus Christ. But he says, come, let us talk. Let us talk it over about the sin problem that is in your life today. Number three, Isaiah 55 and 1 says, listen, everyone that thirsteth, come. Come ye to the waters. He that hath no money, come ye buy wine and milk without money and without price. In a day like today where everything is expensive, the word of God says, come. Come buy wine and milk without money and without price. Amen. You need to come today and drink from the fountain of life, who is Jesus Christ. You can come today and eat of the bread of heaven. He came down. God sent him. The bread of heaven came down upon this earth. You need to eat of the bread of heaven, Jesus Christ. Not to eat his flesh, but to live. That is characteristics, his lifestyle, his holiness, his righteousness, his meekness, and his tenderness will somehow rub off into your life, and you'll become more and more like Jesus. Come, drink from the fountain of life, who is Jesus Christ, our Lord. I close with my last invitation. In Genesis 7 and 1, and the Lord said unto Noah, come thou and all thy house, for thee have I seen righteous before me in this generation. Our world is no more a safe place. Evil and angry men roam our streets day and night. Gates and fences, iron bars, Doberman dogs, surveillance cameras cannot keep away the thieves and the robbers if they want to come and invade. They come to take your money and your jewelry. But I tell you something, there is a more sinister and evil-looking thief that comes. The Bible tells us, John 10:10, the thief comes not but to steal, to kill, and to destroy. But Jesus says, I am come that ye might have life and have it more abundantly. Amen. Come, come thou into the ark, for thee have I seen righteous in this generation. Ladies and gentlemen, that ark of safety is still open today. That ark of safety, it saved Noah from drowning. He, his three sons, their wives, and his wife from drowning in that deluge that rained for 40 days and 40 nights. There's a bigger deluge coming. This time it's not water. It's a fiery judgment that is coming. And you need an ark of safety today. And that ark of safety is found in nowhere else but in the Lord Jesus Christ. Him alone, he can save you. He can save you from the deluge or from the fire of hell that is coming. Can save you. He can save you today. And that ark is still open. And just as God says, Noah, come, Brother Mohan is saying, come to Jesus. If you need an ark of safety, if you need somewhere to hide, he's our refuge. Come to Jesus. Amen. Let's close our eyes. Let's bow our heads. Heavenly Father, I thank you for the short exhortation, Lord. This few minutes we have spent in your word as I stood between you and this people here today. We know it's a funeral session, O God, a funeral service, O God, but I preach not, Father, to the dead or for the dead, but I am praying and preaching today, God, for those who are alive. And those who are hearing me, earshot of my voice, O God, and who can make a concerted and a strong spiritual effort to accept Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior of their lives. Make you, Lord, their Savior, and follow you and to live for you. Bless this fine congregation today. May this funeral service, O God, change the hearts of somebody, Lord, for good in the name of Jesus. We pray as we continue this service, Lord, we pray that everything will be done to honor Christ and to glorify Christ. For we ask it in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Okay, we have one more song to sing, one more hymn again, and it's on our pamphlet. In the sweet by and by. What a song of comfort in the sweet by and by. If you want to see him, he's in heaven, and if you want to see him, you can come to Jesus. Amen.
There's the land that is brighter than day, and by faith we can see it afar, for the Father waits over the way to prepare us a dwelling place there, in the sweet by and by. Shall meet
on that beautiful shore. Come on, in the sweet. Can somebody help me clap and sing? Let's rejoice in the presence of the Lord. Amen. We're going to start that song all over again.
By and by and by, we shall.
On the there's a land that is fairer than day.
That is fair of the day, and by faith we can see it afar, for the Father waits over the way to prepare us a dwelling place there, in the sweet
by and by. And by we shall meet on that beautiful shore. We shall sing on that beautiful shore the melodious songs of the blessed, and our spirits shall sorrow no more, not a sigh for the blessings of rest, in the sweet by and by. We shall meet on that beautiful shore, sweet by and by, how we shall meet on that beautiful shore. Bountiful Father above, we shall offer a tribute of praise for the glorious gift of His love and the blessings that hallow our days.
Come on, everybody!
By and by, we shall meet on that beautiful shore. In the sweet by and by, we shall meet on that beautiful shore.
In the sweet by and by, we shall meet on that beautiful shore. In the sweet by and by, we shall meet on that beautiful shore.
Praise the Lord. We're going to our next part of the service. I'll kindly ask the family members to come around and ask if you want to pray a word of comfort. All family members, and you want to be here, you need prayer, you want to come and be around with them. If you a family member, just come, put your hands around them, come whatever you want to, you know. Praise the Lord.
I love you.
Hallelujah. Oh God, we thank you.
For your mercy never fails.
Father, we thank you. We thank you for the bereft family this evening. Oh God, we thank you for their fine gesture to come to Nazarene Miracle Ministries Church, oh God, today. And to do this service, oh God, of the dearly beloved departed father, friend, brother, uncle, whatever, Lord, grandfather, Lord. Thank you. I pray for this family this evening. Take the handkerchief of your love. Take the handkerchief of your compassion, Lord, and dry the tears from their hearts. Give them a bright hope today. In the name of Jesus, strengthen them spiritually, strengthen them physically, in their minds, mentally, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Touch them. Give them strength, oh God, today. It's not easy, Lord, to send away our loved ones, oh God. There's a vacuum in this heart when we do this, oh God. But Lord, you're a wonderful, loving Savior. You can fill that heart, that vacuum that the seas have left in our lives, oh God. You can fill that place and be a husband to the widows, and you can be a father to the fatherless, and you can be, oh God, Heavenly Father, you can be a God to them this day. In the name of Jesus, bless them and give them strength for the remaining part, oh God, as we go to the cemetery, Lord, to do the final rites and commit, a Lord, that everything will just go fine. We thank you for, we ask it in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you. God bless you, Richard. God bless you. Okay. God bless both of you. God is good. Thank you very much. As we go to the viewing of the body now, and then we proceed into the cemetery. Thank you very much.
All my life.
Okay. After the family members and those who would like to view the body, we ask you to come now. Thank you.
Oh, didn't get a chance to help you. Look at that.
Come on, have a look.
I'm good now.
Everything?
Yeah.
Oh, you mean carrot?
Yeah. Thank you.
The next one. The next one. Sorry. Oi.
Did you sell them?
No, you come in. Would you pass away? Can they put me by?
Yeah,
I'm going to give it a vision. See where they can pass.
Watch.
Through our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose second coming in glorious majesty to judge the world, the earth and the sea shall give up their dead, and the corruptible bodies of those who sleep in him shall be changed and made like unto his glorious body, according to the mighty working whereby he is able to subdue all things unto himself. Father, we thank you. We release his body now in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit to the ground. Cover it under the blood of Jesus. Pray, O God, that it goes into the ground, buries, Lord, but we look for the general resurrection of the last day. We shall all rise and stand before Almighty God to be judged for the things according to which we have done, whether it be good or whether it be bad. Now commit your body to the ground in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen.
Yeah.
The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He leadeth me to lie down between pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters, and he restoreth my soul. He leadeth me to the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. If thou walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me, thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me. All the days of my life I'll dwell in the house of my God forever and forever. Amen. There's a land that is fairer than day, and by faith we can see it afar. For the Father waits over the way to prepare us a dwelling place there. In the sweet by and by, we shall meet on the beautiful shore. In the sweet by and by, we shall meet on the beautiful shore. We shall sing on the beautiful shore.
melodious songs of the blessed, and the spiritual sorrow no more. Not a sigh for the blessings of rest. In the sweet by and by, we shall meet on the beautiful shore. In the sweet by and by, shall meet on that beautiful shore, to a bountiful Father above. We will offer a tribute of praise for the glorious gift of His love, and the blessings that hallow our days. In the sweet by and by, we shall meet on the beautiful shore. In the sweet by and by, we shall meet on the beautiful shore. When the trumpet of the Lord shall sound, and time shall be no more, and the morning breaks eternal bright and fair, when the saved of earth shall gather over on the other shore, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. Oh, when the roll is called up yonder, 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 I'll be there. On the bright and cloudless morning, when the dead in Christ arise, and the glory of His resurrection share, when the chosen ones shall gather to their homes beyond the skies, and the roll is called yonder, I'll be there. Oh, when the roll is called up yonder, 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 I'll be there. Let us labor for the Master from the dawn to setting sun. Let us talk of all His wondrous love and care. Then when all of life is over and the word the night is done, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. Oh, when the roll is called up yonder, 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 I'll be there.
I'm going to sing right through
now.
I am delivered, oh praise the Lord. I am delivered. Glory to His name. I was lost in sin in the valley of death. I am delivered. Oh, praise the Lord. He never failed me, yet He never failed me. Yet my Jesus never failed me yet. And anywhere I go, I want the world to know my Jesus. What is better? Wait, you done that there?
Okay.
Sing, sing.
He is the King of Kings. He is the Lord
of Lords.
Jesus, 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 Jesus. Oh, He is the King. He is the King of Kings. He is the Lord. Jesus, 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 oh, He is the King. What a
a mighty God He serves. What a mighty God He serves.
Sing, sing.
The angels bow before Him, heaven and earth adore Him. What a mighty God He serves. What a mighty God He serves. What a mighty God He serves. The angels bow before Him, heaven and earth adore Him. What a mighty God He serves.
Sing, sing, don't stop singing.
Sing that way.
Who will you sing
a
song
now? In the middle of the night.
Let me hear.
Sing. Come, Pastor.
If you want to see the glory of the Lord, why don't you praise Him? Lift up your hands and praise Him. If you want to see the glory of the Lord, why don't you lift up your hands?
Hey, Byron, did you say you want to sing a song?
Praise Him in the morning, come praise Him in the noon, praise Him in the evening,
praise
Him all the day long, lift up your hands, praise the Lord.
Walk, my man, walk with that next one, man.
When my way groweth drear, precious Lord, linger near. When my life is almost gone, hear my cry, hear my call, hold my hand, lest I fall. Take my hand, precious Lord, lead me on. Precious Lord, take my hand, lead me on, let me stand. I am tired, I am weak, I am worn. Through the storm, through the night, lead me on to the light. Take my hand, precious Lord, lead me home. When my work is all done, and my race here is run, let me see by the light Thou hast shone. That fair city so bright, where the Lamb is the light. Take my hand, precious Lord, lead me on. Precious Lord, take my hand, lead me on, let me stand. I am tired, I'm weak, I'm worn. Through the storm, through the night, lead me on to the light. Take my hand, precious Lord, lead me home.
Amazing. अब चल कर ले मिलन, अब चल कर ले मिलन, अब चल कर ले मिलन। परमानंद का अनुभव कर ओ, परमानंद का अनुभव कर तू, धन्य बना जीवन बिंदु। परमात्मा से है मेरी आत्मा, अब चल कर ले मिलन, अब चल कर ले मिलन, अब चल कर ले मिलन।
I say the same thing, and to the Islam faith, we say the same thing. Greetings, my name is Byron. Kenneth was my big brother, in nothing blood. But, yeah. And so, what I want to say here this evening is not for the day. May God bless my brother's soul, and this is for the living. And, you can't become a Christian in one day. You had a man on the cross, and Jesus bring deliverance. That's the purpose of Jesus in all of your life. The man didn't follow Jesus for 100 years, he didn't go for 10 years or 5 years or whatever. But at the moment when salvation reached to your door, hereby saying here, brothers and sisters who are alive to you.
Get to the point now, man.
Yeah. When they knock on your door, I'm talking about the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. When they knock on your door, don't refuse. Today I am a very happy brother. As a member of the family, we are not blood, but we grew up together. And I want to say that the step that is life and telling family that hey, what, when I die, I want to be buried in a Christian rite. I don't know how far that will go. Let me know something. I don't know how far it will go, but thanks be to God when we as the living could accept the truth. So with that, I want to say, brother, I want to try with me and say, God bless your soul, brother. God bless your soul. Yeah.
Fine, brother.
Summary. Back to nowhere.
Yeah. Hello, friends.
We're about to sleep. So we could turn the at the window at dark. The boredom overtook us. And he began to speak. He said, son, I need a life. Out of reading people's faces, knowing what the cards were by the way they held their eyes. So if you don't mind my saying, I can see you're out of aces. For a taste of the whiskey, I'll give you some advice. So I handed him my bottle, and he drank down my last swallow. Then he bummed a cigarette and asked me for a light, and the night got deathly quiet, and his face lost all expression. But if you're gonna play the game, boy, you gotta learn to play it right. You gotta know when to hold up, know when to fold up, know when to walk away, know when to run. You never count your money. When you're sitting at the table, there'll be time enough to count. When the healing's done. Every gamble knows the secret to surviving, knowing what to throw away, knowing what to keep, because every hand's a winner, and every hand a loser, and the best that you can hope for is to die and see. And when he's finished, turn back toward the window, brushed out a cigarette, get off and sleep, and somewhere in the dark, the gambler he broke even, and his final words I found, the days that I keep, you got to know when to hold up, know when to fall up, know when to walk away, know when to run, you never count your money. Sitting at the table, every time enough is counted. When the deal's done, you got no when to hold, no when to fall, no when to walk away, and no when to run. You never count your money. When you're sitting at the table, there's time enough to count. When the feeling's done, you got no when to hold up. No when to fall up. No when to walk away. No when to run. You never count your money. When you're sitting at the table, there'll be time enough to count. When the feeling's done.
West Virginia, Blue Ridge Mountain, Shenandoah River, life is older, older than the trees, younger than the mountains, growing like a breeze, country road.